Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we take a look at how you can upgrade any Windows Server 2012 R2 cluster to Windows Server 2016 with minimal or no downtime or need for additional hardware. We'll show you how it all works, demonstrate the steps to upgrade, and how you can automate the process with Virtual Machine Manager. So I'm joined by Rob Heinen from the High Availability and Storage team. Welcome.
Thanks, Matt. Great to be here.
So it used to be that you needed to stand up a current and next-gen cluster to upgrade. So two separate clusters, management overhead, extra hardware, and it was quite challenging to upgrade. So how are we solving for that with the new Cluster OS rolling upgrade feature?
With this new capability, we're focusing on minimal or no interruptions to the workload that's running in the cluster. So customers can upgrade that cluster in place. With a Hyper-V or a scale-out file server workload, there's zero downtime. So you don't need to buy new hardware at all.
So it sounds like we're streamlining the whole process, making it easier for admins to stay current and ensure that they can maintain standardized server configurations. But how does it work?
So in the past, you needed to buy a new set of hardware with equal or greater capacity and stand up that new cluster, and then you need to bring down the workload and move it over to the new cluster. And that was disruptive. Mm-hmm. So now, in this case, you can upgrade in place. If we use an analogy with glasses of water, where you basically, the glasses are cluster nodes, what you do is you take one of those nodes, you drain the water out of that, shift it over to the other glasses, then you can move that node or that glass out of the cluster. You can upgrade it to Windows Server 2016, mm-hmm. and then you can move it back into the same cluster.
Right.
And now you enter mixed OS mode, where that 2016 node is fully functional and compatible with the 2012 R2 nodes in that cluster.
And then you can distribute the water across all those
exactly.
nodes.
Exactly. And then you can bring the water back, and then the water is balanced across those glasses or across the nodes in the cluster.
Right. But in some cases, you might not have the capacity to upgrade, or you might want to allow for failover during the upgrade process.
Absolutely right. In that case, customers can actually add additional hardware temporarily into the cluster. So it would be like adding a glass and then draining, you can then drain the workload into that new glass, and then you can pull that 2012 R2 node or the glass out of the cluster, upgrade it, and then push it back up into the cluster.
So is that the end of the process? Is the upgrade then complete?
Well, you have to do that for every node in the cluster. You have to upgrade it to 2016. And then once you're done there, then you update the cluster functional level to 2016.
And that way you can take advantage of the new 2016 features and capabilities.
Absolutely.
Right, can we see it in action?
Of course. So starting here with Windows Server 2016, what I'm going to do is I'm going to launch the Failover Cluster Manager UI.
And this needs to be done on 2016.
Right. Now, I'm connecting to a cluster that we have running here. This is a 2012 R2 cluster. It has three Windows Server 2012 R2 nodes in it. And if we click around, we can see, if we click on these nodes, we can see their versions right there. And so these are all 2012 R2 nodes at the moment. These are Hyper-V machines. Let's go look at the VMs. So here you can see we've got some three VMs, they're running SQL Server. Now let me start an update for you. Here I've written this update loop. Let's start it so that you can see that we're going to be, that we can run this VM as we upgrade the cluster that's underneath it.
So a SQL query executing
right.
while we upgrade the cluster, no downtime.
Should be no downtime.
Right.
So now as we move over, let's grab a node and we'll do a pause drain on that node.
Okay.
And as we do that, you can see what's happening is we have live migration occurring. So that's kicked off automatically for us. And those VMs are now moving over to the remaining nodes or to those remaining glasses.
And live migration, no downtime for the workload again.
There's no downtime. So that update loop is still running for us.
Right.
And now that's completed. Now, if we look over here at the node, we can see that that is paused actually. And so now we can evict that node. So let's do that. And so now the cluster just has these two Windows Server 2012 nodes in it.
Okay.
And we can see that everything's running. Now let's add a 2016 node into that cluster.
Now, we could have gone and upgraded that node in place with Windows Server 2016 and re-added it to the cluster, but we're using additional hardware here.
Right. Well, for the sake of time, I've taken an identical system that has Windows Server 2016 on it. We're not going to validate as we add this node into the cluster, just for the sake of time.
That would be required for a supported configuration.
Yes, absolutely, and recommended as well. So adding the node takes about 20 seconds, and then finally we're done with it. Now this cluster is in mixed OS mode. We have one Windows Server 2016 node in here with the other two Windows Server 2012 nodes.
Okay, so we have this mixed OS mode cluster, but can we continue to run like this?
Of course. We ask customers to run for about, they can run up to 4 weeks. Now in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to live migrate that VM over up-level to the Windows Server 2016 node.
Right.
And there, that succeeded. So this is basically the same process that we do on all the other nodes.
Right. So mixed OS mode, we're still running at the 2012 R2 functional level, correct?
Correct. And so the next step is then to run PowerShell and to actually, once we like it, to actually upgrade the cluster fully to Windows Server 2016.
But at this point, we still could roll back.
We absolutely could still roll back. There's no problem there.
Okay, so can you show us how to upgrade the cluster functional level?
Sure, let's do that. So remember, once we've done the operation and we've drained each node in sequence, we've drained it, we've evicted it, upgraded it to 2016, and then re-added it to the cluster, rebalanced the workloads, then we're ready to run the PowerShell. So let's go ahead and do that. So we just open up a PowerShell prompt here like this. The first command I'm going to run is a query. We're going to get the cluster functional level. So we run that query, and you can see that the cluster functional level is 8. That means it's Windows Server 2012 R2, right? The update cluster functional level commandlet itself is very quick. It only takes a few seconds. We've just now upgraded the cluster, and now we're going to look at the cluster functional level again. And we see that it's 9, which means Windows Server 2016 compatibility.
Okay. What about our SQL Server VM?
Let's go see that. So here on the roles, let's just connect to that VM. Okay, here you can see the query is still running. We just have to scroll down. And there you go. You can see that it should just update.
Yep.
Yep. And we've just upgraded the entire cluster underneath that.
Nice. So now that the entire process is complete, what 2016 benefits can people expect to see?
There are several. So in Windows Server 2016 failover clustering, there's the Cloud Witness. We have VM compute resiliency, VM storage resiliency. There's storage replica. And of course, storage spaces direct.
And many more.
And others.
So is there anything else that we need to do now that the cluster is fully upgraded?
Well, for scale-out file server workload, we're done. But for a Hyper-V workload, what we should do is we should go and update the VM configuration versions so that we can take advantage of the new capabilities of Hyper-V.
Okay, so like shielded VMs, production checkpoints, and many more.
Exactly, and so production checkpoints get you application consistent snapshots, and that's a big deal.
Okay, cool. So that was how to migrate nodes on a smaller scale. But if you've got a 64-node cluster, that manual approach is going to take a significant amount of time. So could I automate this with PowerShell?
Absolutely. So this process is fully automatable. So you could easily write PowerShell automation to automate this process. Or you could use a higher-level orchestrator to orchestrate and make those PowerShell calls as well.
So there is one other alternative that you could use, and that could be Virtual Machine Manager. So let me show you what that looks like to automate the process of the upgrade. So what we have here is Virtual Machine Manager in System Center 2016. I've got a 3-node cluster and a selection of VMs distributed across that cluster. Now in my Fabric view, if we take a look in a little bit more depth at those nodes, you'll see they're all running Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center Edition. So there's node 2, node 3, all configured the same. Now in order to kick off the upgrade process, I'm going to right-click the cluster, upgrade cluster, I'm going to select all of my nodes in this wizard, very simple approach. And now the next key step is to choose a physical computer profile. And this is a VMM object that essentially allows us to control the customization of the target physical machine upon deployment. So what storage, what networking configuration, and so on. So we're going to select a physical computer profile for 2016, and then we're going to move through the wizard. So click Next. I'm going to communicate with these systems using the out-of-band management control specified here. And this is now at the stage in the wizard where I get to customize the final steps of the process. So VMM has already looked at all of these three nodes within the cluster, and it's captured all of the settings, the network config, the storage config. So we don't actually have to change anything unless we really wanted to make some changes. I can just leave things as it is and move forward. We've got a nice summary of all of the steps that are going to be performed. And if I'm into PowerShell, I can view the script that's going to be executed under the covers. I could save that. I could reuse it if I wanted as well. And all that's left for me to do is click Finish, and the job starts. Now, to upgrade three physical servers in a cluster, VMM is going to do a series of steps, and that could take anywhere from 20 minutes to an hour to even longer, depending on how many cluster nodes you've got. It depends on your hardware, the systems, the network, and so on. Now, if we look at one that we've already got upgraded, we can see just the sheer number of steps that VMM goes through to actually orchestrate this upgrade in an automated way. And I'm just looking at one of the upgraded nodes here. So if you look at node 3 of that, you'll see the start maintenance mode is analogous with your drain that you showed earlier. We then evacuate all of the virtual machines using live migration to move them from node 3 to other nodes in the cluster. We evict the node, we clean it up. We then start the process of actually deploying a new node, a new operating system to that physical server using that baseboard management controller for communication. So you'll see here that transfer VHD step. So that's important because VMM is using boot from VHD, deploying a virtual disk to that target server and starting up from that native VHD boot. And that VHD contains Windows Server 2016. You'll see we continue on enabling the Hyper-V role, the clustering features, functionality, configuring all of the networking settings and relevant storage settings as well. And then we finalize the process by updating that cluster functional level and then running validation for a supported configuration. And that is your cluster upgraded. And VMM controls all of that, which is awesome.
Perfect.
Now, it's important to note that there are some system requirements for using VMM. We recommend that you review the documentation for VMM for further guidance for automating your cluster OS rolling upgrades using the link below. So the key question is, where's all this going, Rob?
So moving forward, this is the process that we envision that you will use to move your clusters from Windows Server 2012 R2 to 2016. We've developed this approach with a lot of feedback, and we're pretty confident that we've hit the mark. We think that it'll really allow you to smoothly upgrade your clusters from 2012 R2 to 2016 with minimal downtime.
Thanks, Rob. Great overview. And you can learn more about ClusterOS rolling upgrades at the link below. And don't forget to keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Bye for now.